I'm Zach Friedman, and I'm a freelance prototype developer. I'm not really supposed to talk about my clients, but I got this job that's just too weird to keep to myself. I had my lawyer look at their NDA, and he says it's probably not enforceable. Either way, let's keep this among us, eh?
These clients are weird. They won't show their faces, they'll only talk to me on Discord, and I'm pretty sure one of them thinks they're an apple. They want 3 projects in 1 week because they just let one of their colleagues go.
God damn it!
If you ask me, the whole thing is kinda sus. They want me to build the most thoroughly hated tasks on their spaceship, the Skeld, an upload-download station, a reactor starter console, and a card swipe reader. I only have 1 week to build 3 projects. It's gonna take every dirty prototyping trick I know. Let's bum rush straight to our first task, uploading and downloading. To complete this task, the unfortunate crewmate uses the slowest tablet in the universe to collect data from comms, weapons, or for some reason, the cafeteria, and then upload it to HQ. This is going to be a 2-part project. We need to build the tablet as well as its wall-mounted access point. The number one rule of prototyping is to cheat. Don't engineer something if you can fake it, and don't build something if you can just rummage around in your storage room and find it, like this ancient Galaxy Note 3. This thing is loaded with so much Samsung bloatware, it's already slow as hell, it's perfect. My first thought was to download an off-the-shelf phone case and then build the tablet around that, but Fusion 360 handled that about as well as hardcore gamers handled The Last of Us 2. That means it completely failed, melted down, and perpetuated toxic stereotypes. We gotta do this the hard way. So let's import the reference artwork and bust out the calipers. Well, that was easier than I expected. The model is pretty simple. It's just 2 pieces that bolt onto the phone and add cosmetic elements like the ridge to make it look more like the in-game tablet. I didn't see any buttons on the tablet. Like, I'm not even sure the clients have arms in the first place, so I just added this little pokey hole to access the power button. These hex head screws self-tap right into the plastic because heat set inserts cost money and these guys are paying me an exposure. With that, the models are done, so let's get the printer printing while we design the access point. The in-game access point is just a little sprite on the wall and there isn't any high-res artwork of it, so I took some artistic license to flesh out the details. The light gray areas and the red thingamadingus will be 3D printed to give them some thickness, and I'm just gonna paint the dark areas onto the panel. By the power of vector art, we can reuse this one drawing to laser cut the plate, etch the guidelines, and generate our 3D printed overlays. I cut the main plate on the Fat Cat Fab Lab's laser, I painted it up, and then I got going on the appliques and the frame. Then I accidentally left my screen recorder running for 41 consecutive hours and completely filled my hard drive. Whoopsie! I assembled the tablet, looks rad. I let that thing charge while I ran off another tablet with a hole for the USB cable. By now the paint was drying, so I glued the frame together with some Zappa Gap and I used some contact cement to mount it, along with the Wi-Fi symbol and the red wing doodle, to that plate. I then slipped in the secret ingredient, an NFC tag. This little plastic disc has a self-powered transceiver embedded right into it, and it lets the phone recognize the access point without any battery, circuitry, or baloney. The neat thing about NFC is that it's near-field communication. The phone needs to be nearly touching the tag to power it up and get the data. This will be important. Real programmers write assembler with 8 dip switches and a clock button, but I'm on a schedule, so I use Java. The tablet just runs a simple app that constantly sniffs for the NFC tag and plays the appropriate upload or download animation. The clients insisted that the tablet can only work while the user holds it right up to the access point, making sure their back is exposed and their vision is occupied. That sounds downright aggravating, but the client specifically requested all of this in 22-point bold underlined italic highlighted Helvetica, and that's the most serious font of them all. Let's give it a squiz. Let's have the whiteboard stand in for the weapons room. Let's mosey on up to the access point and initiate the download. It always takes exactly 9.7 seconds, but feels like a sad, lonely, and wasted young adulthood. It'll delete the data and start over unless I hold it in this exact position, so let's upload this data at the other access point here in the cafeteria. And by other, I mean I moved it. And by cafeteria, I mean don't expect production value from a channel that doesn't make a nickel. Note how it will delete all the data and start over if I so much as fart during the transfer. Hypothetically, this would leave you really exposed to some sort of sneak attack. A little stuffy in here. I hope the vent isn't clogged again. By the way, I don't build a lot of cosplay and props like this, so this is kind of new territory for me. Which in-game items would you like to see me build next? Don't worry if it's physically impossible, because it won't be when I'm through with it. Let's see how this... God damn it! Next task, start the reactor. This is the control panel to the nuclear fusion drive that generates the juice to fuel the engines, maintain life support, and bathe the ship in carcinogenic gamma rays. Maybe I should wear one of those suits too. I'm not totally comfortable dealing with gigawatt nuclear equipment. I'm kind of worried the client will put my project straight into production, which will make the reactor dangerously easy to sabotage. But then again, like, they signed a waiver. The activation sequence is 5 random keys, and if the user messes one up, it starts over with a new random sequence. I gotta bite my tongue if I want to get that exposure. The easiest way to prototype this was to build 2 separate devices that talk to each other. I made models off the concept art, and yes, I learned my lesson from the Weekend Projects video, and this time I test fit everything and it helped. The left side is really just a case for a Raspberry Pi with a display, and the right side is the cutest little mechanical keyboard. This is a lot to print. It's 2 bottom pieces, 2 top pieces, 10 LED lenses, and 9 keycaps. I printed the top parts first, and then while the printer chooched, let's move on to the electronics. The left side has a Raspberry Pi 3B Plus and an Adafruit Pi TFT display. I am aware that the Raspberry Pi 4 exists and that my display is cracked, but this project does not exactly demand top shelf hardware. I mean, it's just like a Python script that displays squares and lights the LEDs with Pi game. These aren't real LEDs, by the way, they're just cutouts, and they get illuminated by the display behind them. Sneaky, huh? The right side has more spicy electronics. I popped in 9 extra clicky Kale box white mechanical key switches and 5 RGB LEDs. The microcontroller is a Teensy 3.2. It's basically like a super powerful, super tiny Arduino. And I added a buzzer for sound effects. The keypad is a 3x3 button matrix, which means that the keys are connected in a grid. You see how each row and column is wired together? In a way, we're using code to connect one group of buttons at a time so we can read more buttons with less wiring. I soldered all those wires to a bit of stripboard and added the Teensy and all the resistors and transistors we'll need. The eagle-eyed smartasses among you will probably notice that my prototype doesn't light the keys up the way the real thing does. That is correct, and it actually used to be in the plan. I made the keycaps translucent and I bought some blue LEDs. But we were running a little low on time at this point, so I cut the feature. Finishing projects means making sacrifices, because a simple finished project beats an ambitious pile of parts in a shoebox. Final task, swipe the card. This card reader will go in the ship's admin room and allow crewmates to swipe their ID badges. You see, the life support system is free to play, and if a crewmate doesn't buy a microtransaction every 30 minutes, the ship will disable the toilets. See, this is just a prototype, so the card doesn't actually need to store any data. I just made myself into an Among Us dude with one of these dress-up websites, I forged an ID on my photo printer, and I got to work tracing the game into Fusion 360. A neat little aside, I made sure the project dimensions were correct by calibrating the image. This tells Fusion 360 that the ID card in the reference art was 85mm wide, so it scaled the image to the correct real-world dimensions. You'll notice I made my version a bit shorter than the real thing, because my display is slightly smaller. You'll learn why in a sec. The model is in 2 main pieces. We have a base plate that holds all the electronics, and a face plate that displays the results. The face plate is decorated with these 2 little LED lenses, an aero decal, and a bottle green display filter with a brace glued to it to line the displays up. The filter is laser cut, but everything else you see is 3D printed. I added another Teensy for braining, a beeper for buzzing, and LEDs for blinking. In the game, status messages are displayed on a 20-something digit 14-segment display, but ain't nobody got time to wire that shit up. I just threw a pair of OLED screens in there end-to-end and displayed the messages in a font that looks like a 14-segment display. The hardware here is pretty simple. The card swipe machine just has 2 optical interrupters that detect the speed of the card as it swipes through. Ignore this this groove here, because the card actually swipes sideways. I don't know, man, these clients are weird. An optical interrupter is just an infrared LED pointed straight at a light sensor. When the card passes through, it breaks the beam and notifies the microcontroller. By starting a timer when the card enters the first interrupter and ending the timer when the card leaves the second interrupter, we can precisely calculate how quickly the user was swiping down to the microsecond. If you've done this task before, you know exactly where this is going. I program the card reader to pick a random amount of time and reject the card unless you swipe within 40 milliseconds of it. Of course, it will also reject the card if you don't swipe perfectly straight. Even if you nail the swipe, I programmed it so it still rejects the card 20% of the time because f*** you. That is everything we need, so let's put our prototypes to the test by donning some protective headgear and doing a real-life speedrun of the Skeld.
Gentlemen, someone killed Orange in the cafeteria. I didn't see anyone go in or out. They must have jumped in the vamp.
It was definitely Zach.
What?
I was an admin swiping my card and I saw Zach vent.
Are you serious? I was swiping my card.
Cafeteria vent goes straight to admin. Zach's looking mighty sus.
Yeah, dog, hella sus.
Whoa, guys, hang on. How did Red even know about the swipe machine? I just installed it like 2.5 minutes ago.
Zach's, like, got a point, man. What was Red even, like, doing there?
The real question is, Zach's not even a member of this crew. Where did he get an ID to swipe in the first place?
Whoa, that's, like, sus.
That's mad sus, my dude!
Sus city sarsaparilla.
Guys, I printed it myself. Like, here, take a look. It's not even real.
It's Orange! Sweet Batman's nipples, it's frickin' Orange!
That's like Orange's ID card.
Not cool, man.
You sick son of a bitch.
Oh, come on! I made this portrait on a dress-up site. It has my hair. I even photoshopped a little heads-up display on it.
So killing Orange just wasn't enough. You done rustled his wallet.
I didn't rustle any wallets. I have my own wallet. Oh crap, I threw it over my shoulder in admin.
Y'all right. I've heard enough. I'm voting.
Oh, it is on! It's voting time!
The plurality of relevant testimony, like, totally corroborates Red's allegations.
I'm with you, partner.
No, wait, guys, I'm innocent. I was working for exposure!
You're getting some exposure to the cold vacuum of space.
Got any last words, you backstabbing squirt bag?
Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the future.
Ah!